So welcome back to another Keep Productive video. Today we're exploring Trello versus Asana versus Basecamp. And today we've actually partnered with leading software comparison and review site Capterra to help you make more informed decisions on what software to choose. You can actually use Capterra's wide variety of insights and reviews to help make better decisions. And it's awesome to have them on as a sponsor. You can check out a bit of a versus comparison that they've made in the description below if you want to, with all the information that you need. Today, I'm bringing together my knowledge to review these applications. So let's dive in. Now, Trello, Asana, and Basecamp are project management applications. They're really designed for those who are looking to coordinate their team's efforts and really drive a goal forward and have everyone on the same page. So let's start with availability. Now, Trello, Basecamp, and Asana are available on all devices. As a project management experience, they are probably all, I guess, these three are probably the most well-known, most credible out there on the market. So it's great to have them on all of the devices that you use. So let's take a look at pricing. Now, the pricing varies on all of these applications, but is a little bit similar in a sense because they're relatively priced. So let's start with Trello. Trello does have a free plan. Now, there are two sort of pricing plans to this. You've got a $5 pricing and a $10 pricing per month. All of these have obviously more varying features. However, the $10 pricing, which I think is called premium, is actually the pricing that includes more of the more advanced views that Trello have been adding more often. Trello also locks some of the automation features with their acquisition Butler in some of these plans. So I think premium plan gives you the best overall experience, and $10 per user per month is a fairly reasonable price in the project management space. Now, Asana follows suit. They have a free forever plan, but they have a £9.49 per user per month pricing for the more advanced feature sets, including timeline and things like that. But again, it depends how many team members you're bringing on, but it really depends as well what sort of features you want, because Asana do stuff a fair amount of good features in their free plan. But again, if you're looking for that additional views, they tend to lock it inside of the pro plans. So Basecamp is probably the outsider when it comes to pricing. It's a strange pricing, but a nice one depending on your situation. So they charge a flat rate of $99 per month for as many users as you like. So for example, if you're somebody that has a team of 500, you're still gonna pay $99. Say you have a team of five, you're still paying $99 per month. So it's good for larger teams, less so for smaller teams, but again, it does give you and you buy into the plan. But there is a personal plan which allows up to 20 users and three projects overall. So there are some limitations on the personal plan, but again, the personal plan is much more suitable for freelancers that have a few clients or a very small team in that case. So folks, if you want an in-depth reviews on all of these applications, Trello, Asana, Basecamp, you can check out Capterra. I recommend doing it because what people leave in there is feedback in context to their situation, which I think a lot of people will find value in. So check out the link in description below and you'll find those reviews super helpful, especially when you're finding you need to see what other people's experiences have been. So let's take a look at the features. Now let's start with Basecamp whilst we're on the topic. Basecamp differs from Trello and Asana because it really focuses on what's called asynchronous communication. And that's very simply the focus on you're not actually communicating in real time with your team members. People might be dotted around the map and you also might not want to disturb them in real time because they might be focusing on their piece of work. So asynchronous communication really does, it adapts to that, allowing you to communicate whenever you see fit with each other. A little bit like a very, very slow game of tennis with the ball being left in each other's court each time you whack it. It is much more thoughtful as an application. It does have everything from to-do lists to chat to a message board and really personal project productivity management as well, not just for your team, but also for yourself. and it is really deemed as the hub of teamwork. It's much more a solution for remote teams. However, it's been sort of praised as one of the most well-designed productivity experiences for teams. Now take a look at Trello. Trello's been in the market for absolutely ages, and a few years ago, they were acquired by a company well known in the space called Atlassian. Now Trello thrives on an experience called boards. Kanban boards essentially allow you to organize your projects by dragging them between different states, and that can be adapted in a variety of situations, but it really does fall from the method in the 1980s, the Kanban methodology, which was used at Toyota. They have more recently added new formats, including table, timeline view, and they're adding more, including calendar view and additions that will be available in the premium pricing. Now, Trello has this sort of underrated feature, in my opinion, called Butler Automations, but it does allow you to create automations that are built inside of Trello that connect with other applications that save you a bit of time. So you can, for example, have, when a task is ticked off inside of Trello, have it update a Slack thread or something like that, that really just keeps your team in the loop, and also do other things that help you to just keep your Trello account clean automatically. Now, Asana is the much more traditional solution in this sort of set of resources. It's really well designed. They have a gorgeous board view and more recently a timeline view to help you and your plan, you and your colleagues plan in Gantt view, which is very nice. And the integrations in Asana are sort of oozing out. They probably have the most advanced set of integrations out there. And Asana are really well known for putting a lot of time and attention into their development process before they release a feature. So who are these recommended for? Now, I would probably say Trello is best for those people that are more Kanban focused and those who are willing to pay a bit more for automations, because I think it's a killer feature that a lot of people want to really take more advantage of. Automations really do sort of power up your Trello account, and you can access more pre-created templates and also pre-created automations that you can easily plug in and play with. So I would say Basecamp is probably best for an asynchronous team that is remote, and more for those who want a company-wide hub management versus a really in-depth project manager. It's really for those who are not micromanaging their team, because obviously it doesn't give you a hideous amount of insight when it comes to reporting and things like that, like Trello and Asana do. But at the same time, it's a great experience for being able to bring your team together. But in my opinion, I have to be really sold on the concept, and all of your team members have to be sold before investing in it. So Asana, again, much more traditional, and I normally recommend it for those in marketing, sales, and product teams. It's one of those applications that you can pretty much give to anybody in the department, and with a basic level of project management skills, they would understand it and be able to get right on with it. It's great for collaborating together as well, and the integrations help you to connect it to existing applications that you might already have. So folks, that was Trello versus Asana versus Basecamp. Hopefully we help you make a better decision around it. A huge thank you to Capterra for sponsoring today's feature. You can check them out below. And a huge thank you to everyone who watched today. If you're new here, it'd be great to have you as a subscriber. But thank you very much.